Dr. Chaturvedi, my friend Ajit, Dr. Arupam Verma, Dr. K.C. Arora, Dr. Lok Gupta and Dr. Sahai, the faculty members of Bimtech, most importantly, the passing out students of Bimtech, the two-year programs, their parents and guardians. It's really a privilege for me to be here and to, especially on this occasion when I can congratulate you and then wish you all the best for the life ahead. And I want to take this moment to really congratulate you and your parents and the faculty for having done such a splendid job. And let's give them all a big hand in Indian. I've been lucky that I was here about 10 years ago to talk to a group of fresh students, and now I'm seeing the students passing out and pushing them along into the social world. And I must therefore take this opportunity to say that apart from the pledge that you have taken, and I hope you will remember it all your life, you must remember that also the vision of your institute carries the very important word of ethics. And I think this is something that I hope you will remember, that you will follow the highest ethics that you can, that you've learned, and the highest values that you've imbibed in this institution. And the two things that I really want to emphasize today for this young friends is, one, that you must promise to yourself that you will work for your country and for your nation first and foremost, and to make it the best country in the world. Because by the time you grow up, and by the time you are about 50 years of age or something like that, this country would already be the third or the second largest economy in the world, and it will be a global power. So you will have a responsibility, and therefore you must uphold the name of this country and therefore also the institution, and work towards its greatness, towards achievement. The second thing which I wanted to emphasize, which I'm sure all of us remember, is please never forget to respect your elders, your faculty, your parents, and all the elders that you have in society. This is an Indian value that I hope we will remember, and this is a value that I unfortunately see not being remembered, not being followed as much as it should be. So please remember that it is because of them, because of your elders, that you are what you are and you will become what you will become. So for your lifetime, you must make sure that those values remain with you. And so all the very best for your coming years. And in this context, I did want to read out a very small quotation from Mahatma Gandhi, who is of course associated in spirit with this institute through the Birla family, with whom he had such deep connections. And he had said that there are seven social sins, and I quote, seven social sins, and all of them you will notice are very relevant today. Politics without principles, wealth without work, pleasure without conscience, knowledge without character, commerce without morality, science without humanity, and worship without sacrifice. I hope you will remember these seven principles as you go forward in your life. All the very best. Friends, young friends, as you go out, let me assure you that you are going into a country which is going to be a new India. This country is at the cusp of a transformation. It is at the cusp of a major transformation. I can feel it in my bones. I've been watching this. I've been working as an economist for 40 years, and I've seen how the economics has grown. I've seen that there have been other aborted takeoffs in this country. We've always had the potential, but we've never really taken off. But I want to assure you today that with all the work that's been done in the last 5 years, and all the work that promises to be done in the next 10 years, this country will achieve the much awaited transformation and will break out from its low income status into a middle income status. I see a future for this country where it will grow at least 8% per annum, if not higher, for the next three decades. And it will grow with, while taking the people at the bottom of the pyramid together with them, and it will grow in a manner which will take care not only of the weak, of our society, but also take care of the ecology and the environment, because we in India have never believed in conquering and wasting our environment. We have believed in preserving and living with our environment on the motto of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. And so I think you'll be getting into a new country, you'll be getting into a new India, and you must be prepared for that. And I say this with a lot of sincerity, because I worked in the government during 91 to 95, 89 to 95, when the other major reforms had been undertaken. But I, having worked then at that time, and now being fortunate enough to be working again, I can tell you that the kind of work, that the amount, the number of reforms that have been undertaken are far bigger, far more difficult, far more complex than what were undertaken in the earlier stages. You know, you must have heard of the insolvency and bankruptcy code, the GST, the RERA, you know, the Benami transactions tax, you know, the zero corruption at the highest levels of the government, zero tolerance for corruption, the ease of doing business. And in essence, in sum total, you are now seeing the beginning of a development state in India, which will replace the so-called soft state and the crony state or the corrupt state. And that development state would mean that India will deliver to its people what is required and what can be sustained for the next three decades. So we in NITI Aayog have been very fortunate to be a part of this. And I was told by Mrs. Jayashree Mota that I should tell you about NITI Aayog, and this is our great pleasure to do so. And NITI Aayog has been at the right middle and center of all the policy reforms that have been taken in this government in the last four and a half years. You know, you talk about education, Dr. Chaturvedi mentioned them. It was the NITI Aayog that the committee was created for education, set higher education reforms, and we were the ones recommending the autonomy, the graded autonomy, the accreditation, the multiple accreditation committees, etc., nearly two years ago, and all of them are now coming into fruition. NITI Aayog was the one where the entire reform of the Medical Council of India was formulated. And that's now, as you know, is now a bill pending in the parliament, and we will do away with the corrupt institutions that had taken over the medical education in this country and replace it with the Indian Medical Commission as we go forward. The entire Ayushman Bharat was incubated in NITI Aayog. The PMJ that you now hear about, which will promise ₹5 lakhs medical health insurance to 500 million people in this country, was incubated in NITI Aayog and then handed over to the health authority. I am the chairman of the National Nutrition Commission, and which is the nationwide commission, and we have the target for reducing this absolute dismal blemish on our country that 38% of our children are still undernourished. And you will be glad to know that in the last 3 years, according to a UNESCO survey, this percentage has already been brought down to 34% from 38%. And therefore, the rate of change has increased from 1% per year to 2% per year. So the National Nutrition Mission is being inspired, is being done in NITI Aayog. We've just recently completed the recommendation of the oil and gas sector, whereby we want to liberalize it, we want to increase the exploration and production. The e-mobility mission is housed in NITI Aayog, and we will take care of the fact that we will create a new form of digitized, electric, shared and connected mobility in this country in the decades to come. I can go on, but I can tell you, for example, the two initiatives that we are leading now is one on integrative medicine. It's high time that our own traditional forms of medicine, of Ayurveda, yoga, homeopathy, and Siddhi and Yunani all come together and get the recognition that is due to them by integrating them with scientific endeavor, by making them as good as the others. For all policy work, NITI Aayog has become middle and center, and this is why the Planning Commission was replaced by NITI Aayog, because the original work of the Planning Commission in the 50s and 60s was this kind of think tank work, which, however, was displaced or misplaced by the work that it took on itself for distributing so-called development finance to the states. But NITI Aayog, therefore, is the principal think tank of the government, and we are open. I always, for policy work, I always give the analogy of NITI Aayog being a funnel with its mouth open towards you all, towards the civil society, towards the industry, towards the academia, to get new ideas, to get breakthrough ideas, to get out-of-the-box ideas, which we can then put into the system through the NITI Aayog efforts. On the other aspects of NITI Aayog is, one, improving accountability in the government. And for that, we have an organization within NITI Aayog called the DMEO, the Development Monitoring Evaluation Office, which now does real-time monitoring of the work being done by ministries on a performance basis. And every 3 months or so, we report these to the Prime Minister, who sits there for hours together to look at how the ministries have done vis-a-vis the performance, vis-a-vis the targets that have been set out to them. And the DMEO is now going to examine and evaluate more than 700 schemes that are there in the government, and to present a real-time based evaluation of the output and outcomes that they have achieved. So we want to improve the accountability of this government. We want to make sure that what the government does, what it's supposed to do, the government fulfills its mandate in a transparent, efficient, and accountable manner, because that's the key for putting in place the development state that we are so wanting to do, because without which we will not be able to achieve the kind of growth, and inclusive growth and sustainable growth, that we are all aspiring for. The third trend that we've done, and which you already know to some extent because of the establishment of the Atal Incubation Center, innovation ecosystem in the country. And the Prime Minister, when he established the Atal Innovation Mission in NITI Aayog, charged us with the responsibility of changing the innovation system from school upwards to the universities, to the higher education, and to the incubation centers, so that we have, in the last 2.5 years, ladies and gentlemen, unbelievably, already established 2,700 Atal Tinkering Labs in secondary schools. And we are going to set up 5,000 within the next 2 months, and the target is to establish 20,000 Atal Tinkering Labs all over our country, so that our young children are introduced to the latest technology, to the latest equipment, which I am told by the people studying in IITs who are coming there as mentors. And we have, by the way, 18,000 mentors enrolled on voluntary basis from all over the country, and they are working with these Atal Tinkering Labs, and these mentors tell us that this is the equipment, which is either the optic sensors or the 3D printers or the robotics and robotic arms, which they were introduced only in the labs when they entered the IITs, and we are giving them to the children who are 14 and 15 years of age. So that's the Atal Tinkering Labs. We've got 21 Atal Incubation Centers already working. We will establish 50 within the next 2 months. That's the target. We have, at the same time, you've got Atal National Challenges, whereby we give, I think, 2 crores of rupees to anybody who can come up with an innovative idea. And finally, we're already starting on a program called Arise, which will make sure that in 6 ministries, you've got 60 crores each for helping the small and medium enterprises to make their innovations more fruitful and to test their prototypes and take them from TRL 3 to TRL 8 stage. And this is something that will happen within this year. So the entire ecosystem, and then, by the way, under the Atal Innovation Mission, we are also now trying to create a synergy between the public sector science and technology system under the CSIR and the ISAR and the DST, and the private sector science and technology establishment, because the two must come together. The two other work that we do, apart from this was not enough, is to, one, foster what we call competitive federalism in the country, which is to make the states compete with each other. Because we know that unless we do that, our real improvement will not happen in the economy. And for that, we have published several rankings, several index indices across many sectors, in which we rank the states and the changes that they've got over the years, because we want to put them in the public domain so that we can name and, if you like, reward them and also sometimes shame them into greater competition. And this is what I believe will achieve what I call the democratic dividend the dividend that we must get out of our democracy, out of our very diverse, pluralistic, vibrant democracy, because once the states start competing with each other, I think there'll be no stopping this country. And at the same time, we also do cooperative federalism, which is to get the best practices from everywhere in the country and pass them on to the other states so that they can make use of them and they can make the best of them. Gentlemen, I know I've gone on for a little while, it's already quite late for all of you, but the Prime Minister has not only given us the mandate and the responsibility, but has also empowered us by giving us the amazing flexibility in recruiting people from outside the government system. We have now today in NITI Aayog, it's amazing to see about 100 young people from all over the country, all over the world, just going around and bringing us new ideas and bringing us new energy, so that lateral entry has been permitted in the NITI Aayog. For the first time, the head of the Atal Innovation Mission, Mr. Ramanan, is somebody who is on deputation from Tata Consultancy Services to us, because we can't afford his salary, and he is working with us. And there's a synergy between the government, the public, and the private sector. With this mandate and this responsibility, and we also had our first offsite retreat in NITI Aayog, probably the first ever for any government department, in ISB Mohali for 3 days. I assure you that you will see NITI Aayog emerging as a real powerhouse of change and reforms in the country in the years ahead. So please look out for NITI Aayog, go to his visiting website, and I hope that some of you will find the inspiration to come and work with us. Thank you very much for listening.